Whatever God does, He does for His glory. Whether He forgives, He creates, God always acts for His glory. In Psalm 25, verse 11, the Bible says, "For thy name's sake, O Lord, pardon mine iniquity, for it is great, for thy name's sake." In Psalm 130, verses 3 and 4, "If thou, Lord, shouldst mark iniquities, O Lord, who shall stand? But there is forgiveness with thee, that thou mayest be feared or reverenced." When we realize God is willing to forgive the most heinous crimes. In Psalm 106, verse 8, "Nevertheless, He saved them for His name's sake," referring to the Israelites. God always acts for His glory. This is particularly the case with creation. Psalm 19, verse 1, "The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament sheweth His handiwork." In Isaiah chapter 6, verse 3, "The whole earth is full of His glory," all above us, all around us. If we look carefully and honestly, we will see evidences of the goodness of God. All of creation was designed to glorify God. But the Bible also tells us in Isaiah 43, verse 7, "I have created him for my glory." Who is him? God is referring to humanity. When God made Adam and Eve, He made them for His glory. The Bible tells us the heavens were for His glory, the earth for His glory. Now, who should reflect the greater glory? Those made in the image of God, because the heavens and earth were not made in His image. On this holy Sabbath day, my listening friend, my message is simple. As you take your nature walks and you admire the things of nature, the beauty around you, remember that God requires His greatest expression of His character, not in a flower or in the sun or the moon, but in you and in me, because you and I were made in His glory. As you keep the Sabbath holy, may the Lord bless you and empower you to reflect His glory like nothing else on earth can. God bless you.